If you've decided on Wix as your website builder, you might be wondering about the best way to get started. As you've probably discovered, Wix offers a ton of different options for building a website, each with its own pros and cons. In this video, I'll show you the quickest and easiest way to get up and running with a stunning Wix website. Follow me as I take you through each step, from getting started to publishing a fully functional Wix site, all without spending a cent. Now, Wix caters to a huge range of industries and niches, from online stores, creative industries, professional services, hospitality, and more. In this tutorial, I'll be setting up a website for a good friend of mine, freelance illustrator Kim Lee. But if you're building a simple website, the steps should be almost identical, regardless of what industry you're in. That being said, if you're after a more specific tutorial, like how to build an online store using Wix, let me know in the comments below so we can make sure to cover that in a future video. Today we'll be going through how to pick the right design for your site, editing images and text, adding a contact form, editing the mobile version of your site, and finally, publishing your Wix site. Also remember that you can jump from chapter to chapter at any time using the progress bar at the bottom of the video. The first step is to sign up for an account if you haven't already. You can head straight on over to wix.com or use the link in the description below. The great news is that you don't need to pay to start building a site, or even to publish it, so no need to pull out your credit card just yet. Now, the following few steps may or may not be exactly as you see here, but if not, don't worry because you'll still end up in the same place. You'll be asked who you're building the site for, but I would just skip this step so that we can start building our site as quickly as possible. You'll then be asked whether you want to use Wix Studio, which is the advanced version of Wix built for agencies and freelancers. Since we're just getting started, let's hit Continue to Wix. I'd also recommend skipping the AI chat assistant as I find you have much greater control over your Wix site's design if you choose your own designs. But if you want to use it, that's totally fine. Enter the type of website you're building as this will match you to the best templates. In our case, we're going to choose Illustrator Portfolio. You can then tell them your website's name and what it's about, if you'd like AI to generate some copy for you. Or just skip this step altogether. I'll add in a bit of text here. In the next step, you'll be asked which features you want to add. You can choose as many as you like, but I'm just going to stick with Showcase Creative Work for now as I don't want to clutter the site. Don't worry, you can add any of these features later on. Let's hit Finish. You'll then be taken to the dashboard. There's obviously a lot here and it can get a bit overwhelming, but you don't need to worry about all that now. All we want to do at this moment is click on the Design Site button. Rather than choosing the AI option, let's pick a template, which will give us more control over the design of our site. Here we'll be taken to Wix's template library, which has already been filtered down to your chosen category. Of course, you don't have to stick to your category, there are plenty of others to choose from. However, sticking to your category means that your template is more likely to have all the relevant features included, which means less work for you. You can hit View to preview the template and even see its mobile version. If you're happy with it, go ahead and hit Edit. A word of warning though, once you choose your template, you won't be able to switch it, so make sure it's one you really love. You'll then be taken into the Wix editor, which is where you'll be editing the design, content, and layout of your site. You might get prompted to enhance your content with AI. We're going to skip that, but feel free to take advantage of it if you need a little help with your website copy. Now, while there are a lot of options in the editor, we're just going to be focusing on the main ones today. However, I definitely recommend taking the time to explore each one on your own, especially if you're really looking to personalize your site. Let's start editing the content of our site. The great thing is that Wix's visual editor is super intuitive and lets you edit anything you see on the screen. All you need to do is click on the element you want to change. So let's start with this introductory text. Simply click on this section, then the quick edit button. It works like any text editor. Just select the text you want to edit and replace it with your own. Let's do the same with the site title in the top left. Just double click and enter your text. But I also want to make room to add an image in this introductory section. Because Wix's editor is drag and drop, you can move elements around however you like. So let's click on this text block and drag it to make it narrower, leaving space on the right to add an image. Now let's go to our left menu here, which is where we can add in new content. Click the Add Elements button and choose Image, then Upload Images. There are actually a lot of different sources you can pull images in from, including social media or Google Photos, but I'm going to upload it from my computer. I'm going to choose my image, and once that's uploaded, add it to my page. I can click and drag it into position. It's looking good, but I actually want to use a circular frame rather than a square one. So I'll choose this paintbrush icon to edit the design, then change it to the frame I want. But as you can see, Wix lets you do a lot with your images, including crop, filter, and even animate them. So again, feel free to play around with these features. Now this template comes with a gallery of portfolio pictures, but obviously we want to replace them with our own. Let's take a look at how to do that. All we need to do is just click on the gallery, and as you can see here, choose the Manage Media button. We're going to select all of these images because we want to delete them. You'll then be asked to add your own media. So let's choose some images. Again, we're going to click Upload Media here and choose the images we want to add. You can use your keyboard to select multiple items using the Control, Command, or Shift button. Click Open and just wait for the images to upload. Those images will then be added to your image library. As you can see, we already have the image that we've previously uploaded. We just want to add the newly added images to our gallery, so we're going to select all of them using the Command or Control button on your keyboard to select multiple images at a time. Then let's add them to the page. If you'd like to rearrange the order of how they appear in your gallery, you can just drag and drop them. If you're happy with the layout, you can keep it as it is. But as you can see, our images are cropped a little funny because they're square, and this gallery is built for rectangular images. So let's change the layout by going to Settings. Click Layout, then choose a different layout that might work better for your images. In our case, we're going to try out masonry. As you can see, that's looking a lot better. So our site is really starting to come together, but what we still need to do is personalize it so that it matches Kim's unique style and brand. Right now, the colors and the fonts still feel a little bit generic, so let's change all that. We'll go back to our left menu over here and choose the site design option. Here is where we'll be able to choose the theme of our site and change its colors and font. You have a few different options here, but the easiest way to change your site's design is to go for a preset theme. So let's choose Change Theme. We're going to go with the Fashionable theme. As you can see, that's changed the colors and font of the entire site to give it a little more personality. However, you can still go into your editor and tweak individual elements, such as the font. For example, the Explore My Portfolio title looks a little small to me, so we can select that and click Edit Text, then adjust the font size to make it bigger. Now, up until this point, we haven't saved any of our work yet, so it's probably a good time to do it. If you just hover over the Save button at the top, you'll see that autosave is off. You can turn it on by using this keyboard shortcut, but you can also save it manually by hitting Save. You'll then be asked to add in the domain you want to use. This will be the free domain Wix gives you. If you'd like to use your own domain, you'll either need to buy one from Wix or connect one you've bought elsewhere. We have some guides on tooltester.com on how you can do that, and I've also linked to them in the description below. Today though, we're just going to use Wix's free domain, so let's type in the URL we want to use. Hit Save and Continue. Your page has now been saved, but it hasn't been published yet, which means others can't view it. We'll do that at the very end. Now, one of the biggest things you'll probably want to do with your website is get new business. So let's add a contact form where Kim can capture new inquiries. Some templates already come with this included, but as this one doesn't, I'll show you the easiest way to add it in. Let's scroll down to the bottom of the page to where we'd like to add the contact form. If you hover over where you'd like to add it, you'll see this Add Section button pop up. Just give that a click. Now you can use this to add a whole bunch of different elements to your site, but I'm going to scroll down to Contact. Let's choose a contact form design we like. In this case, I'm going to use this one with the map, although I'll actually be removing the map. So now that's been added. As with the rest of the site, we can just go ahead and edit all the elements that have been added in. The first thing I want to do is remove the map because we don't want to show that. Just select it and hit Delete on your keyboard. Then we can change the text of all these elements by double-clicking and adding in your own text, such as your address, phone number, and email address. Here you have your social block. You might want to remove it, but it's probably a good idea to keep it in if you're looking to promote your business or grow a community online. Just click on this section and you'll see the Set Social Links button come up. If you click on that, you can add and remove the icons you want to display, but also change the links so that they point to your social profile. Once that's done, we can just drag and drop all the different elements if you find that they're not so well aligned after making those edits. Now let's go to the form. You can edit all of these fields in case you'd like to remove fields or add your own by choosing Add New Field. I want to keep all these fields, so I won't change that. But what I would like to do is make sure that Kim receives an email notification anytime someone submits his form. So if we go to Form Settings, then choose Setup, Email Notifications, you can set your email notifications here. You'll be taken back to that dashboard that we saw earlier, and you can add any additional email addresses here. So we're getting very close to being able to get our awesome looking site online. Let's just do a bit of tidy up to make sure it's looking perfect. Anything you don't want can be deleted by just selecting it and hitting Delete on your keyboard. So for instance, we're going to delete this menu in the header here as our website will just be a single page for now. But you can always add it in again by finding it in the left toolbar here. Let's also make sure our footer looks okay. To change any of these social links, just click on it and hit Change Text. There, you can change both the text and the link. We can also edit this text at the very bottom to include our own details, so let's do that now. Again, just select the text you want to edit, then click Edit Text. I'm pretty happy with how that's all looking, so let's hit Save. There's just one more thing we have to do before we publish our site. I've noticed that many websites published on Wix often forget this step, but it's an important one. Let's switch to the mobile view of the site by clicking this mobile icon. Wix automatically generates a mobile version of your site, which is what anyone browsing on their phone will see. However, it's not always perfect, so it might need a little bit of manual adjustment. The first thing I want to do is remove this menu in the top right with our delete button, as we don't need it. If we keep scrolling down through the site, we'll see most of it looks okay. When we come to the contact section though, there are a few elements that look misaligned, so we can drag and drop them to the right place. There's also quite a lot of white space below the form, which I want to reduce, so I just need to drag this arrow to move the footer up a little higher. Now, these changes shouldn't affect the desktop version of the site, but it's a good idea to go back and double check it anyway. If all is looking okay, let's go ahead and publish our site. This step is super easy. Just head on over to the big publish button at the top right of your site. And your site is live. You can click on this button to view your site. Because we're using a free site, you'll see a banner ad at the top of your website. To remove this or to use your own domain, you'll need to upgrade to a paid plan. We have a detailed guide on Wix pricing, which I've added a link to in the description below. There are a few other things that we haven't covered in this tutorial, like adding new pages or optimizing your site for search, but I've also included a link to our guide on Wix's SEO features below. Creating a professional-looking Wix site is that simple. Of course, there's plenty more you can do with a Wix site. So if you'd like to learn more about how to start selling online, take online bookings, or even run email marketing campaigns, make sure to Google Tool Tester Wix. And of course, drop your questions in the comments section and I'll do my best to get back to you as soon as possible.